for reducing of transpiration, for prevention of water loss, and okay, so that is that physiologically, okay, adjustment and morphological adjustment, they are the genetically fixed, okay, so that stem is modify to perform photosynthesis. Okay, that is the open sheet. It is also known as a cocti. It is also known as that cocti. Okay, for example, CAM plants. CAM plants. CA plants means crassulaceous acid metabolism plant. Plants. Okay. So generally they are the succulents. Example, succulent xerophytes. Okay, so generally for the prevention of transpiration, okay, in these plants for prevention of transpiration, okay, stomata open at night and close at daytime. And closed at daytime. For that, prevention of transpiration. Stomata open at night time, closed at daytime. Okay? And also, they having that thick cuticle. Internal cavity, thick cuticle. Okay? After that, stomata are present in deep pits. So this all are that, okay, characters about that CAM plants. Okay. Generally, stomata is present, okay, outside that epidermis, on the epidermis, okay, they are involved in the transpiration. But in the xerophytes, in CAM plants, for the prevention of water loss, so the stomata are present in the deep pits. Pits means holes, okay. After that, plants are, okay, growing the different regions. First one is the halophytes. The plants are grown in salt soils. They are also known as salinity of soils or salinity of soils. They are known as that halophytes. It means the plants are grown in salt soils or salinity of soils. Okay, so they are known as that halophytes. For example, rhizophora and avicennia. Rhizophora and avicennia. So the plants are grown in salt soils or salinity of soils, so they are known as that halophytes. Okay, after that heliophytes. The plants are grown in grown in direct sunlight. The plants are grown in direct sunlight. They are known as that heliophytes. Okay, so heliophytes means generally the sunflower. Okay, example sunflower, generally mesophytes, all mesophytes. After that sciophytes. The plants are growing in shady regions. The plants are grown in shady region. They are known as that sciophytes. So this is sciophytes is example mosses. Okay, that bryophytes. Okay, so they are known as that, depend upon the showing of the different type of the plants, they show the different adaptations. After that, plant communities. Eugen warming. Danish botanist scientist. Danish botanist okay botanist plant communities are plant communities are divided into three groups, or plant communities are divided into three communities. Based on that, based on that, plants are depend upon water. Based on the plants are depend upon water. There are three types. Based on the plants are depend upon that water. So there are that three communities. First one is the Eugen warming, Danish botanist. Plant communities are divided into three communities or three groups. Based on that, plants are depend upon that water. Depend upon that water, plants are divided into that three groups. First one is that hydrophytes. The plants are grown in The the plants are grown in water areas or wet conditions or wet conditions are known as hydrophytes. The plants are grow in water areas or wet conditions are known as hydrophytes. Okay. Hydrophytes are divided into 5 groups. Hydrophytes are divided into 5 groups or 5 types. First one is that free floating hydrophyte. Free floating hydrophytes means the plants are freely float on the water. Okay, so they are known as that free floating hydrophytes. Free floating hydrophytes means the plants are freely float on water they are known as free floating hydrophytes. For example, to take that first one is that Fistia. Icarnia, Lemna, after that Salvinia, the plants are freely float on water, they are known as that free floating hydrophytes. These free floating hydrophytes are Fistia, Icarnia, Lemna and also Salvinia. Okay, for example, the diagram in that Fistia,